Good morning, everyone. We thank God so much for today, the 5th of February 2018. We give God all the glory and all the praise for a wonderful day He has made. Today we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I want you to wake up, wake your neighbor up, share this quiet time right away on your timeline, invite all your family and friends to join in. And let's speak in tongues as we do that, and let's trust God to speak the word to us this morning. The word that God has for you is going to transform your life, your marriage, your ministry, your organization, your company, your business, your academic life, every aspect of your life. All you need is one word from the Lord. So please share this quiet time, come back, click on that same share button, scroll down, and start inviting all your family and friends to join in. So together we can start our day with a blessing. And guess what? We are going to partake in the Holy Communion today. And as my Father, Bishop Dagonis, leads us, the power of God will touch you wherever you are. You will be healed, you will be delivered, you will be saved in the mighty name of Jesus. I want us to speak in tongues as we invite and share this quiet time right away in the name of Jesus. Lord, this morning we praise your most holy name. Thank you, Lord, for the beautiful day you have made. Thank you, Father, for your mercies towards us that are brand new this morning. We give you praise, we give you all the glory. Thank you, Lord, for taking us through the entire weekend. Thank you for providing. Thank you for protecting us. Lord, we would have been utterly consumed if not for your mercy. We thank you, we give you praise. Thank you, Lord, for being such a loving Father. We honor your most holy name this morning. Take your place in our lives. We ask you to take your place in our lives. We yield ourselves to you this morning. Holy Spirit, fill us one more time with your awesome presence. As we look into your word, Lord, we pray that you fill us with the spirit of wisdom, revelation, and understanding in the knowledge of you. Lord, we wait on you. We pray that you speak a word to us, the word that will transform our lives forever. One word is all we ask. One word, Lord. Your word is all we need, Father. In the name of Jesus, speak, Father. Your word is all. Speak, Lord. Yes, Lord, your word is all we need. Your word is all we need, oh God. Speak to us this morning. Speak to us, oh Lord. Show us the way that we may go, Lord. We wait on you this morning, that you lead us, Father, that you direct us, Lord. Show us the way that we may go. We're waiting on you, Father, to lead us, direct us. Show us the way that we will go. We wait on you to lead us, direct us. Show us the way that we will go. Yes, Lord. Yes, Father. Thank you, Father, we give you praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, and grant us the grace to be doers of your word in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Give God praise. Hallelujah. Good morning one more time. My name is Pastor Mrs. Engineer Jim Bright, and I bring you the quiet time written by my father, Bishop Dr. Heward-Mills, on behalf of my husband, my pastor, my king, my Lord, my covering, the one and only living man, the Reverend Peter Bright Sr. He is my all-time best producer and the visionary behind this program, Quiet Time with Mrs. Mandate. And I give God praise for the privilege given to me to help him fulfill the mandate upon his life. I thank God so much for the grace that is bestowed upon him. He was in Calabar over the weekend and God used him amazingly. There was a revival in the land and we just give God all the glory. All the glory. We thank God so much. Today we are looking at the topic, fight anew. Fight anew. You cannot continue doing things the same way if you expect to have a different result. I say that again. you cannot expect to do things the same way when you are expecting a new result. If you want something different, you need to do things differently. God is a God who does new things. Every now and then, He does new things. And God wants you and I to learn from Him as His children. Let's read the story of David, this popular story of David killing Goliath, and we shall glean a few lessons from there. 1 Samuel chapter 17, we shall read from verse 1 to 10, and then we'll jump to verse 48. 1 Samuel chapter 17. Now the Philistines gathered together their armies to battle, and were gathered together at Soko, which belonged to Judah, and pitched between Soko and Azekah in Ephes Damim. And Saul and the men of Israel were gathered together and pitched in the valley of Elah, and set the battle in array against the Philistines. And the Philistines stood on a mountain on the one side, and Israel stood on a mountain on the other side. And there was a valley between them. Verse 4. And there went out a champion out of the camp of the Philistines, named Goliath of Gath. Now that was a champion, someone who was experienced at war, who had won many wars for the Philistines. Now get the Bible gives us detailed description of how he looked like, his stature. And my husband says that God did not put these details just for the sake of writing. These details show how gargantuan our problems can be. Sometimes you are faced with a Goliath, you are faced with an issue that you just do not know where to turn to. Nothing seems to work. What you used to do doesn't seem to work any longer. The problem is so huge, greater than you. And when you look at it, you get frightened and consumed by fear. That is what Goliath looks like. So the Bible says that his name was Goliath of Gath, whose height was 6 cubits and a span. And he had an helmet of brass. Look at that, an helmet of brass upon his head. And he was armed with a coat of mail. And the weight of the coat that he was wearing was 5,000 shekels of brass. And he had greaves of brass upon his legs, and a target of brass between his shoulders. And the staff of his spear was like a weaver's beam, huge. And his spear's head weighed 600 shekels of iron. And one bearing a shield went before him, and he stood as if all of the way he looked, how he was a giant, his huge stature and the way he was dressed, as if in the spear in his hand, as if it was not fearful enough, he stood and cried unto the armies of Israel. Verse 8, and said unto them, why are ye come out to set your battle in array? Am not I a Philistine, and ye servants to Saul? Choose you a man for you, and let him come down to me. If he is able to fight with me and to kill me, then will we be your servant. But if I prevail against him and kill him, then shall ye be our servants and serve us. Verse 10, and the Philistines said, I defer the armies of Israel this day. Give me a man that we may fight together. When Saul and all Israel heard those words of the Philistines, they were dismayed and greatly afraid. There are times that we are faced with a Goliath, we are faced with issues, and we are totally confused and greatly afraid. But guess what? There is good news for you. God is about to speak a word of deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus. Verse 12. Now David was the son of that Ephrathite of Bethlehem Judah, whose name was Jesse, and he had 8 sons. And the man went among men of an old man in the days of Saul. And the 3 elder sons of Jesse went to follow Saul to the battle. And the names of his 3 sons that went to the battle were Eliab the firstborn, and next unto him Abinadab, and the third Shammah. And David was the youngest. And the 3 elders followed Saul. But David went and returned from Saul to feed his father's sheep at Bethlehem. Let's jump all the way to 48. So David originally was not in battle with his brothers. He was feeding the lamb, the sheep that God had, that his father had asked him to feed. He was not qualified to go to battle. His elder brothers were qualified, and his father sent him to take food to them and all of that. So verse 48, and it came to pass when the Philistine arose and came and drew nigh to meet David. So David had come to the battle. He was and he said that, who is that uncircumcised Philistine? Let's just read it. Verse 44. And the Philistine said to David, come to me, and I will give thy flesh unto the fowls of the air and to the beasts of the field. For the sake of time, I do not want to read the whole thing. But David goes to battle. And when he arrived there, he said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine that is talking and putting the name of our God in repute? So he said he could fight against him, and that God had given him the bear, the lion came, he tore it apart and all of that. So they armed David, and they put the helmet on him and all of that. But David could not move, and he said that no, he was not going to use it. He hadn't tried this before, and he wanted to stay with what he was used to. So, verse 45, then said David to the Philistine, thou camest to me with a sword and with a spear and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defied. This day will the Lord deliver thee into my hand, and I will smite thee and take thine help from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air and to the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel, and all this assembly shall know that the Lord saveth not with sword and spear, for the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hands. I want you to remember, when you are faced with a gargantuan situation or problem, know that the battle is the Lord. If you call on the name of the Lord, the Lord Most High, he is the one who is great in battle. The battle shifts from you to the Lord, and God will protect you. God will fight for you. God will deliver you, and God will cause you to win. And sometimes all you need is an idea to come out of that situation. What you need is just a word from the Lord to come out of that situation. Verse 48, and it came to pass when the Philistine arose and came and drew nigh to meet David, that David hasted and ran toward the army to meet the Philistine. And David put his hand in his bag and took thence a stone and slung it and smote the Philistine in his forehead, that the stone sank into his forehead, and he fell upon his face to the earth. So David prevailed over the Philistine with a sling. Something that was so small and unusual, with a sling and with a stone, and smote the Philistine and slew him, but there was no sword in the hand of David. Therefore David ran and stood upon the Philistine and took his sword and drew it out of the sheath thereof and slew him and cut off his head therewith. And when the Philistines saw their champion was dead, they fled. They fled. All you need is a new idea to overcome that problem that seems not to go away. All you need is a word from the Lord that will transform that situation and turn it all around in your favor and bring you victory in the name of Jesus. When we are faced with a situation, my husband, the mandate says, the Lord, what do I do? What do I do? I need a new idea. And sometimes the new idea you probably need is written in a book. If only you can get hold of that book, because someone has gone through that situation. All you need is God to lead you and direct you into a book. And if you can read it and capture that idea and glean, meditate on it, it will transform that situation to the glory of God. People have read these books and have transformed their lives, their marriages. And we have amazing testimonies of how people, for example, I've read Church Growth, I've read the Mega Church, and their churches have shot up from 300 to 3,000, exponential growth. What is it that you need from the Lord? What problem are you facing? Is it a financial problem? All you need is God to speak. And God has used anointed men of God like my father, Bishop Dagionis, and have written the word in a book. Let's not be like people who have the resources but do not read it. And there is this amazing proverb that if you want to hide something from a black man, hide it in a book. Because why? The black man will not read and find that idea, that solution that he or she needs to transform his life. I want you to get these beautiful books. What is it that you're looking for? Every topic has been treated right here in the Macarius 60. Be it marriage, be it leadership, be it church growth, be it finances, be it shepherding, whatever. Administration, everything has been written in the Macarius and in the Montano. All you need is to call the numbers that are about to hit your screen and place your order. So my father, Bishop Dagionis, says that the Philistines and the Israelites were engaged in a long battle in which neither could gain the upper hand. They had been camped there for days and just challenging each other, and Goliath coming and frightening them. The Philistine had presented Goliath as the man to beat. If you were able to beat Goliath, then you won the war. The two sides stood across the valley looking at each other, with neither being able to gain the upper hand. The new idea that broke the stalemate was a new and unknown warrior called David. This new warrior had a new weapon. Catapult. No one had used this weapon in a war, and no one was expecting it. Goliath certainly was not expecting a little boy with six pebbles to approach him. He was taken off guard, and that was the end of the stalemate. Stalemate is a place where you get to where you are not moving, you are not making any progress. Everything you try to do just doesn't seem to work. You are just at a plateau. If you are engaged in a power struggle with your associate, you may have to deploy a new idea different from your old ones. A new idea different from the old ones you have been doing. You have to do something new. continuing to do the same thing in the same way with the same intensity and expecting a change, I'm sorry to say, is madness. Continuing to do the same thing in the same way with the same intensity and expecting a change is madness. If you have to be, if you have been experiencing marital turmoil, for example, and conflict for many years, you need to think of a new approach to fight an old problem. A new approach to fight an old problem. Sometimes the key you need is in a book. The key you need is in a book. In that book, you find a new idea that may break the stalemate. That is just what you need. A new idea. That is why real leaders love books. Real leaders love books because they know therein lies the secret. Therein lies the secret. They know that there could be a secret on a page that would make a difference to their whole lives and ministries. What you need is a new idea. And that new idea has been written in the book. You need to get that book and find it. That is the word of God to you. God wants you to make it this year, 2018. It's your year of good things as you stay connected and prosper. As we stay connected to God, to our spiritual Father, our spiritual Father, and prosper. I want to introduce these books to you. This is The Art of Leadership. This book teaches you the art. Leadership is an art. We are all leaders. We are either leading our lives or leading others. Even if you are a mother, you are leading your home. As in, not leading as in being the head of the home. Leading as in being a homemaker. Managing your home, directing things in the kitchen is leadership. Taking care of the children is leadership. Training them with the guidance of your husband is leadership. So you're either leading, every one of us is a leader in one level of one capacity or the other. We are leading ourselves or even leading others, leading companies, organizations, ministries, all of that. So this book teaches you the art of leadership. Leadership is an art. The more you learn it, the more you practice it, you acquire the art and sharpen your skills of leadership. We are where we are today. The mandate is doing amazing things because he has gleaned into these books, practicing the art of leadership. And this one, The Good General, is the science of leadership. Leadership is both an art and a science. So this one teaches you the science behind the leadership. You need to get this book. And you also need to get this one from the Montana. This one is a combo. This is the art and science of applied leadership. These books are not like just any other leadership book that just gives you theories without any practicals. These are practical books that have been tried, tested, and proven to work. So this is a combo. This gives you the art and the science of leadership. This is part of the 11 textbooks that make up the Montana. I want you to call the numbers that I've scrolled on your screen and place your order for the Macarius and for the Montana. You get The Good General and The Art of Leadership, this one, from the Macarius. And it will be a blessing to you. The idea you need has been written in a book. These are scriptural-based books. I want you to read something amazing to you. Our God is a God that does new things. Our God does new things. New things all the time. New things all the time. Isaiah 43, verse 19. God says right here, and he's prophesying to you and I. He says, behold, I will do a new thing. I will do a new thing. now it shall spring forth. Now, not tomorrow, now, today. God wants you out of that marital turmoil. He wants you out of that financial difficulty. He wants you out of that place where your church is plateauing. God wants you to get into that level of prosperity that you yearn for. He wants that for you more than you even want it for yourself. And God is saying, now it shall spring forth. Ye shall not know it. I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. How is that possible? A way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. That is like an impossible situation. So if you are faced with an impossible situation like the Goliath, or you will find yourself in a desert, in a wilderness place, God says, behold, I will do a new thing. A new thing. A new thing. It's only a new thing that can make a way in the desert, in the wilderness, and make river to flow in the desert. Only a new thing. If you keep going round and round in the desert, just going round and round the way you were going round before, and thinking that the river will spring forth, you find water, it will not be so. You need to change direction, change course, do something new, just like our God. Our God is in the business of doing new things. And right here in this book, I want to read a few things for you. Our God is a God of change. He's doing new things, and we all need to embrace new ideas with honesty. My father says that try a new method. A new way of doing things may be the key to pushing you out ahead of everyone else in the field. Everyone else, for you to have a competitive edge in your business, in the business sector, you need to try something new. Something new. Five examples of new things that God does. For example, Isaiah 43 verse 19 is a scripture I read to you. God embarks on new projects, new schemes, new plans, new ideas. Mark 16 verse 19, God gives us new languages. Yes, and these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. God gives us new languages. John 13:34, God gives us brand new instructions. He gives his servants brand new instructions. God gives instructions, and every instruction he gives actually has an expiring date. So probably God may have spoken to you 2 years ago, and probably that instruction has expired, and now you need to get God to speak again. A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another. A new commandment, a new instruction I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another. John 13:34. God makes us into brand new people who have never existed before. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Hebrews 8:13. God makes new agreements, and he issues fresh calls to service. Fresh calls to service. So if you are open, you will hear his voice. In that, he said, a new covenant he had made the first old. Now that which decayed and wasn't old is ready to vanish away. That's Hebrews 8:13. So God does new things. God is in the business of doing new things. What you need is to fight anew. Fight anew. Change your strategy, glean into the books, and get and capture that new idea and do it. When God speaks to you, do it. It's not enough to hear the voice of God and not do it. You need to do what God says. And God has spoken to you this morning. practice it and do it in the name of Jesus. We've been praying between the porch and the altar. Our Father Bishop Davionis have been leading us to pray between the porch and the altar. And God has spoken, and God has been speaking to us. It is time for us to do what God says. Let's fight anew. Let's fight anew. Let's glean into the books. Therein lies the secret, the new idea that we need in order to win the battle. God bless you for joining in this morning. I see so many people who have joined. God bless you all so very much. I see right here Reverend Dr. Richard Udo joining all the way from Lagos. God bless you for joining in. I see Sister Miguel. God bless you for joining in all the way from Abuja. I see Tolu Oni. God bless you all, and many, many others. God bless you so much for taking time out to join in. Your mandate is crystal clear in the mighty name of Jesus. It is time for us to take the communion. And if you haven't shared this quiet time or invited someone to join in, the power of God is about to hit the screen and hit the airwaves and come right where you are. Why don't you share this quiet time and invite your friend, tap your roommates to join in as we get ready to partake in the communion this morning.
The cup of blessing that we bless.
Amen. I receive it. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Right now, I see something like a rope, professor, tying somebody.
Yes.
With a lot of knots. But I command that the rope to be untied.
Amen.
And I release you from every knot and bondage.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus, yes.
To those watching,
yes.
To those here, I declare and proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord for you.
Amen.
It is a good year for you.
Amen.
It is a year of good things.
I receive it.
May God visit you, and may His visit result in every change.
Amen. Amen. I receive it. Amen. Amen. Yes. I receive it. I receive it. Yes. Amen. Yes. Yes. Amen. New things. Yes. I receive it in the name of Jesus. New beginnings. Amen. Yes, Lord. Yes. I receive it in the name of Jesus. Yes. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Yes. In Jesus' name. Amen. Yes. Amen. 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 Yes. In the name of Jesus, I receive it in Jesus' name. Yes. Amen. Amen. I will live. I will live and not die. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We believe you have been blessed by the preaching of God's word. For audio CDs,
hallelujah.
DVDs, books, and other resources by Guy.
We give God praise. We give God praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your healing. Thank you for the new things you brought our way. Thank you for deliverance from sicknesses, from cancers, from destructive things and decisions, and delivering us from experiencing the effects of our mistakes and bad decisions that we have taken. Lord, thank you for a new beginning. And just as my father, my prophet, have spoken, Lord, in the next 8 weeks, I receive my breakthrough and my new beginning in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And I believe you have received yours to believe it and walk in it. New things, new beginnings, it's yours for the taking. Subscribe to my daddy's podcast. All you need to do is to download podcast on your Apple device or podcast addit on your Android device, and just look for that one. You'll subscribe to the podcast and enjoy and benefit from all of his messages. Get the books, lean in them, and get a new idea to implement. So I'll come your way again tomorrow. Like this page, share it. Like our other official pages, that you're listening to Peter Crusade and Peter Price Senior - The Mandate, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Is The Mandate TV, so you don't miss out on anything that The Mandate shares with us. I've come this far because I've been under his feet and learning, and I'm so most privileged, and I want you to enjoy that as well. So please like all the pages, subscribe to the Mandate TV on YouTube. God bless you. Your mandate is crystal clear in the name of Jesus. You are going through this week victorious. New beginning is your portion. It's a new season. It's a new day. This year is a year of good things in the mighty name of Jesus. I'll see you tomorrow. By the special grace of God, 6 a.m. GMT plus 1 is the time. Remember that you are a daughter and a son of the Most High God, who created the whole world and everyone and every single thing in it. Therefore, you cannot be a victim of your circumstances. You are a victor. You are more than a conqueror, says the Lord. See you tomorrow. Have a glorious day.